in upcoming years. The original home was built over 500 years ago in the Ming Dynasty. And now, for our theme, The Reflection of China, is a 360-degree circle-vision movie which will last for 14 minutes. During the show, you will visit our people and many other famous cities and buildings, such as the Great Wall, the Forbidden City, Tiananmen Square, Beijing, Shanghai, and my hometown, Hong Kong, and much more. So, are you all ready for the movie?
Yeah!
Great! So now please bring all of your personal belongings and stay behind the grey carpet until the doors are fully open. Thank you! Safety, please do not sit on the new walls. Also, there's no eating, drinking, smoking, or flash photography inside the theater. As a courtesy to others, please silence your cell phones. If you'd like to leave the theater for any reason during the show, please push the red doors on your left-hand side. In China, we say 谢谢, which means thank you. So everybody, 谢谢. I hope you enjoy the show, 谢谢.
Ah, China. When one thinks of this magnificent country, one cannot help but envision the Wanli Changcheng, the Great Wall. It once stretched like a mighty dragon across 4,000 miles of China.
Welcome. I am Li Bai, a poet of the Tang Dynasty. And I have returned to share with you reflections of my beloved China. Like this great wall, it winds like a road across timeless landscapes. But one can also find landscapes that are ever changing.
Reinventing itself. Vibrant, sophisticated, romantic. As Shanghai reflects modern China, historic Nanjing Road reflects modern Shanghai. Set your gaze across the Huangpu River and you will find a new China that reaches for the sky. Yet in this city of East meets West, one can still find treasures of Shanghai's stately European influence. Even in the hectic pace of modern China, there is always time for Tai Chi, a tradition that has endured for centuries. Up here on Huangshan, at the Sea of Clouds, painters and poets like myself have been inspired for generations. In China, we say a poem in every painting, and a painting in every poem.
We have had a long history. Much of it has been recorded in this fashion. However, it may be said that the history of the Chinese people is not written in ink, but with water.
The mighty Yangtze River. A fellow poet once wrote, "Traveling against the currents of the Yangtze is more difficult than climbing to heaven." That may have been once true, but no longer. this great river, through mountains and valleys, touches the lives of 500 million Chinese. There is no better example of China's harmony with water than Suzhou. This ancient city sits on the longest man-made waterway in the world. When Marco Polo traveled this way, he called Suzhou the Venice of the East. I suppose if I had traveled to Europe, they would now call Venice the Suzhou of the West. So vast is China that even within her borders are many exotic lands and contrasts. From the serenity of Heavenly Lake to the busy night market of Urumqi. Here one discovers that Xinjiang province is home to many ethnic peoples with their own unique customs and their own unique cuisines. Finds travelers on the ancient Silk Road, the same road that over 700 years ago brought Marco Polo to these very gates. The gates of Jiayuguan, the extreme western end of the Great Wall. A visit to Inner Mongolia shows us a reflection of an earlier time. Here, the nomadic people still live much as they always have. Far to the south is Yunnan province, home to many of China's national minorities. The cultures of this province are as diverse as the landscape, like the Shaolin Stone Forest, one of nature's unique wonders. In the far northeast is Heilongjiang. Although winter here can last 6 months, the people celebrate by carving magical sculptures of ice.
China's past.
Peking Opera. In the center of Beijing is perhaps China's greatest legacy, the Forbidden City. Imagine courtyards that could hold 100,000 members of the Imperial Court. For 500 years, this vast walled city was the home of 24 emperors, the sons of heaven. But today, all the world can pass through this gate.
Goodbye. 再见. Thank you. Have a nice day.